So we're, are we ready to start?
Yes.
It's a word for, I can't remember what the word is, but.
Right, it's a story.
How everyone can get into singing.
On the same.
Same thing happens in a fascist rally as well.
We will, right. They all frown at the same time and sigh, and suddenly they feel their togetherness.
Yep.
Cindy, you need a pool of water?
We love pool of water.
Anybody else need a pool of water?
It's okay. Thank you.
Cool. Maybe you for ask, I'm just a guest.
Oh, no, we're happy to have you there. Did everybody find out if you're a swiper or a sticker? Yes?
Yes.
Okay.
Obviously, no.
No, you're not a swiper or a sticker yet?
Are you a swiper?
You tell me.
Are you a swiper or a sticker?
I like to swipe.
Okay.
Hello.
Come sit down. Okay. Laura is a sticker. Before we get started, welcome to your first day on the job at being employed during the meeting. Don't usually do this, but out of necessity, you have all been employed. Sorry.
Do you have the name tags?
Okay.
You're going to be a sticker, just so you know.
Okay.
Okay. You must be a sticker.
All right. Camelon?
Yes.
You're a swiper.
I am.
Okay. Again, it's not typically my MO to distract you while we meet, but this is a necessity situation, so.
Okay.
You don't have a job yet, but you're taking notes. Sorry, lady. You can thank me tomorrow. Okay. Swiper, sticker. Okay. So, swipers, you're working on the front side.
Okay.
Stickers, you're working on the back side. Okay. Swipers, raise your hand. You have a pen. Okay. Okay. Your job as swipers is to find that leaky date after on in the 1, 2, 3, third paragraph. Please join us. You are swiping Thursday through Sunday, October 6 through 9, period.
Got it.
And then you're going to set it to the side and kind of give it a little bit of, you might want to, when you stand, when you stack them, like kind of collate them a little, what's that word?
Stagger them.
Yeah, stagger them very much because it just needs a second to kind of this is not science. This should just fit and you should be able to just go move on. Perfection is overrated. Chances are it's going to be in a third grader's backpack And they're not even gonna look at it because what we want them to see is stickers. You are on the back side. On the back side, under Join Artist Pat Millbury, there is a where and a when. You're removing said sticker and sticking it over the top. It is not gonna be perfect. Perfection is overrated. Okay?
I hear that should be helpful.
Perfection is overrated. I'm sure I'm not with them.
Yes, I think so too. It will be my answer. I like that.
So we're just gonna stick them on and then when you're done, we're just gonna keep it to ourselves. And at a certain point, we're gonna find a friend, sticker, find a swiper, swiper, find a sticker, switch, and keep doing it. If you wanna switch your job because you're like, sticking sucks, don't tell a swiper. Just say, hey, swiper. One is white, one is dead. And they might fall for it.
Okay.
People who have just arrived and have not utilized your red and green dot situation. I think there's one and two.
Yes.
Do you have a red and a green dot?
Yes.
Your red and the green dot is before you start your job. Your first job is to go over and look at the quotes that were sent along.
Uh-huh.
And I want you to think of, if our public places have like vision statement or a slogan or not a brand, no, but a rally statement, tagline on your cup or your billboard, which one would you pick? Your red is your heart, the one that you love the most. Your green is, I like that. But the rest are
okay.
Dot away. In the meantime, yes.
Thank you.
And thank you for working at the museum today. Your check's in the mail. Or in the candy bag. Actually, they don't have it. Okay. All right. Madam Chairwoman, that is, I think, it right now. Now I'm officially good. I'm ready. Sorry about that. Okay,
I'm going to call the meeting to order at 6:09. I think I pretty much got everybody on the roll call for the meeting.
We should probably read them out for the sake of our video.
Randy, Teresa, Danielle, Pamela Badger, Stephanie, Nettie, Jennifer, I'm guessing two public to be heard?
No. We have one. Yes, it has to go on.
Yes.
And
Laura, and me, Cindy.
And Melanie.
Okay.
So we're missing officially
Laurel and Iris.
Laurel, Iris, and Susan Horowitz.
And Melanie.
Okay, so public invited to be heard.
Just need a name.
Marla and Marla.
Welcome, Marla.
Thank you.
I'm sorry, I want to tell everybody I'm having a lot of trouble hearing in this echo room, so. I'm sorry, your name again was?
Marla, M-A-R-L-A.
Are you just a guest, or do you have something to say?
Okay.
Does anybody else want an agenda, written agenda, printed agenda?
Did everybody get a chance to look at the last month's meeting minutes? Any changes, corrections, questions? Need a motion to approve?
I move that we approve last month's meeting minutes.
I second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Additions to the October 20th agenda?
Yes, I need to please add an item 13 called Emerge Remediation, and then subsequent item, new business and commissioner's comments will move down appropriately. And that's the only agenda item I have to add.
Shakita is not here right now. Sister Cities project update.
Jody Bliss was very, very excited to receive news and welcome of the project. She has reviewed the contract, it's been through city attorney's office, and she says that it's in the mail, which is very great news. She also said that she has already ordered materials, so that means that she's working. The color palette for the piece, we will need to revisit, because one of the things that the selection panel had said, I should have brought up the visual, but the seats are kind of a rainbow color, so we'll need to revisit those colors. So you can expect that.
And the color of the building.
Is the exterior staying the same blue color then?
And we don't have to make that decision at right at this moment.
Oh, okay, I see. All right.
I think the coding is less than that, so we have a couple of those.
Yeah. I need to make sure that we are under contract with her before we go into that.
Spoke project update.
All right, you guys are probably, you folks are going to probably need to take a break from your hard labor. I know, see, isn't this fun? I just cut right to the chase. So, if anyone has been over to, and I don't know why I didn't go take pictures, anyways.
I sent you pictures.
I know. Not working.
They're on your computer.
They're not working. This computer is not working. If you've been over, you've seen the mural that is now complete, that is now sealed, and the changes that were made. More hummingbirds were added, but also this yellow swoop came down and has extended down in this other area.
Also, I think the other ones too, the orange and the
other ones. Uh-huh, yeah, right, on the other sides. So, it looks fantastic, and then a number of you came out to meet AJ and to give the thumbs up approval before we seal. So thank you for making your way out there, that was wonderful. The second phase of the project, as you'll recall, is this optical, he called it AR actual reality, which is this binocular system. The binocular system was put into a delineated line item in the budget, in his existing budget. So those dollars are already allocated. After further review and spending time in Longmont and looking at it from afar, AJ has come to us today to say that he does not think that this is a wise use of funds. It's anywhere between 10 and 20% of the budget, which is $6,000 to $12,000.
Wow.
And so I appreciate him being cognizant of the fact that this isn't maybe the wisest use of funds. So he is coming to you with an alternate proposal, which would mean an amendment to the contract and a reallocation of the funds within the existing budget. So he's not asking for more funds. So if you go inside from the alleyway into the spoke building and you step down, this is where you step down, and there's this brick bit on the left, and then there's, and then you kind of keep walking in, and there's the bike racks and everything, and then there's this wall. And so he says, wow, yeah, it's a nice wall. So he drafted that and it sent it along, and I said, well, number one, we're breaking precedent, but at the same, like, this is very much not the norm, right? Like, once you enter into an agreement and a contract with somebody on their proposal, like, that is what you've contracted. But I appreciate the fact that he's being cognizant of use of funds. So I asked him what all of this would entail, and he will not only be doing, so the orange is the outline, right? So it's that kind of cattywampus diagonal wall, and then the flowers will be part of an AR augmented reality.
Oh, really?
With your phone, and the flowers will bloom. And so it, part of the new contract would be, or the amendment to the contract would be, 1 year's worth of him paying for the subscription for 1,000 views a month. That's a lot. And then we have to figure this out, but what the ongoing situation would look like if he keeps the contract for like 100 views a month for some number of years, or if Art in Public Places will have to enter a service agreement with the animation software.
How much is that?
No, I have no idea.
So basically what you're saying is that you look through your phone and the flowers bloom, but if you don't look through your phone, they're not there?
No, they're there.
They're there, okay.
They're animated. If you hold, you have to download the app.
Yeah.
So obviously we would have somewhere that you buzz a QR code, the QR code leads you to the app, you have to download the app, and then you can, so it's kind of cumbersome.
Yeah.
We're
all used to doing that.
Yeah.
I wanted to ask about the, so like, you know, the church that I think about, I don't know if I wrote this to you or not, but my daughter, like, friend and I went out and looked at it, and it is very high, like, you really have to crank your neck, right, to see it. And there's another level below that looked like it would be a campus. No.
So all of this.
Right at the entry. It's like right at the entry where this is where I was thinking. You know what I'm talking about?
Oh, you mean that?
No, like, okay, so.
Round the corner?
Yeah, okay, so if you're standing, okay, let's just say you're standing and you've got the whole thing up here, right? And then you've got the whole thing here. And then there's like a strip over the short entryway into there. So you would be standing out here. Let's see, yeah. You're standing out here in the alley. It's right above where that is. Yeah.
So you can't see that from the street. I can't see probably why.
No, but you can see it before you walk through the breezeway.
Well, yeah, the alley. You can see it from the alley, but we wanted to see it from Main Street.
So
yeah, I know, but the breezeway, it actually would be nice if it was put up in there.
I do know what you mean.
Yeah.
So
look at the pictures that I sent you.
So the most important aspects of this whole conversation lies on the fact that we don't own this building. We have to get an easement agreement, and the easement agreement has to go through city council, and the building owner has agreed to what we've already done and is agreeable to this.
Okay.
Do you remember, I don't know if you remember, when we did the God, my brain is not working, forgive me. When we did the presentations for this building, we had a gentleman and he came to us. It's right there. It's that spot right there.
Yeah.
When you're walking down the alley and then there's a breezeway, this breezeway faces south, right? So anyway, we asked the building owner at that time, that side, right? This side here?
Yeah.
Yep. So we asked them if they would include that in the easement, and the answer was no. But Lauren has gone back to them, and now why? I could not tell you, because that is by far
the most
visible, the most attractive. I could not agree more. But
yes, in fact, my daughter and I were like, oh, it's such a shame.
It's kind of a lost opportunity.
Yeah, even we went into the top of the roofs and we were like, no, it's kind of hard to see.
Yeah. No, it's not easy to see. So that being said, so the matter at hand is that they don't agree. Again, don't ask me why. Not this section, right? But this and that, they will agree. Timing. To get the easement through city council is not a quick process. If you are agreeable and this is the direction that you would like to go, then I will get it on the city attorney's agenda and we'll try and get it, the easement agreement, done by the end of the year, and then he's ready to paint pretty much right away. Yeah.
Could they just amend the existing agreement?
Very good question. So the city attorney said that we can do one of two. We can amend the existing agreement, which is probably faster from a legal standpoint, and then getting it in queue. But from a collections management, and for the Angela and Eileen of the future in managing legal businesses, the two easements is cleaner.
It's easier.
So he gave us the option. I look at you. I
totally agree, because they're so removed.
It's too
easy. In 10 years, we're not
going to make maintenance at different times, too, just because it's exposed and it's not.
Yeah.
Agreed. So, but I mean, the terms are going to be the same, which is good, right? So when it comes to that legality piece of it, I don't think it's going to be as hard. The other thing, is we probably will amend our existing, because some liberties were taken.
Creativity?
And this is the easement. And this was painted. So were we, now, does it probably make that big of a deal? No, but is it the right thing? So anyway, so we'll probably have to go back to legal one way or the other. So the question at hand, of course, is twofold. Number one, as a commission, if you would like to accept or deny the artist's proposal for amending his existing contract to apply the designated dollars for the binocular system to a new mural with 1 year of 1,000 views per month, that's the agreement at this time, knowing that Art in Public Places is going to be responsible for some amount of ongoing maintenance for the views.
Or not. So it can't just be something we do for a year and then we just retire it.
Yep.
Okay, so One of Daniel on the selection committee, who else is on the selection committee?
Randy.
Okay, so let's hear from you two about what you think about this.
Hey.
I'm really disappointed personally.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I'm not. I really love this. I think it's really beautiful. But that's not the concept that was agreed on.
Sure.
And I understand taking those binoculars and like not utilizing them. To me, that's fine. And we can maybe do away with that.
Yeah.
That was part of the reason why I really loved that piece to begin with, was to be able to add that different piece of it.
Mm-hmm.
To me, this is hidden. I don't think you're going to get a lot of recognition from that unless besides people that are actually living in those apartments, which is totally fine, but also I worry about the cost moving forward after that the most. I think if he maybe just painted it and left it as is without that extra piece maybe, but I also feel that, well, is this even a possibility to just be able to just get that money back potentially, because we can utilize something just like this in a more public space in my eyes, where I don't know, I feel like this is a very, I'm really unfortunate part of it, because personally I would have chose different artists, just knowing the design and where the concept and where it was going. But that's just me in my opinion. So
no, and it's a good one. This is definitely breaking precedent, which
yeah.
is a very valid point. It's like when you start breaking precedent, what does
Devil's
the contract
advocate
mean?
Devil's advocate, it is right on a breezeway.
Mm-hmm.
If people park on
in there, they'll come for Hoffman.
Is
they
that
just
public
walk
parking
through,
right through
there?
There is.
No.
So all this building is public parking.
Oh, I didn't know. Okay.
There's public parking within the building. It's not just. That's a parking garage for public use. Yeah.
Also being on the selection panel?
Yes.
I was, I mean, the binocular thing was kind of a good idea. I thought it was a decent idea. I'm not sad to see it go because I know it'll get damaged. Oh, no, we fixed it on a continual basis. Can you speak up just a little bit? Yeah, I'm not sad to see that thing go necessarily, because I know it probably caused problems now in the future. I like the idea of the mural inside the garage. I'm that. I don't think it needs to be AI, but I could go either way. But I do like getting another block that, yeah, this kind of thing could be somewhere else, but maybe that's another object also.
I think that because we are contractually bound to this artist of this project, that the dollars are allocated and are encumbered,
yeah.
Period. So I think we're at a, I have to refer back to, like, again, policy and procedure is the way we need to go. So it's this or that, not both. That's about the step we go in the most important.
So the building wasn't constructed when you agreed to the contract, right?
The building was under construction when we agreed to the contract, and the easement agreement happened while construction was happening.
Okay.
But to be fair about the easement agreement, there's a lot of cooks in that kitchen. So, and this is my very, I'm an art history person, not a lawyer. Explanation of how this works, but you have Boulder County Housing Authority, who I believe in time will eventually like own this bit, or no, I'm sorry, Boulder County, which the Housing Authority offices in, and it is also affordable housing, et cetera, et cetera, and public parking, et cetera, et cetera. The county owns the building. County doesn't pay for the building outright. Of course, there is a money man, right? So the money man is the one who also has vested interest at this point. So within their own construction of agreeing to what things are going to look like and before the designs are blessed and all of that, it goes up and it comes back down. And all these power people look at it. And then the county tells us, yep, we agree. And the city, us, and the county have an agreement ourselves too.
Okay.
So there's a lot of moving parts. So the fact, again, that we executed the first easement agreement took a long time. And the fact that we have, again, spit and handshake, that they will execute this easement agreement for this is pretty far down a road that takes a long time to get down.
Yeah.
So I think
to where you are now takes a long time.
Yeah. So if, and again, the dollars on this project are encumbered, right? Mm-hmm. So these dollars have been allocated and are contracted with others. So one way or the other, extracting the dollars, like getting our money back, that's not possible.
It's not possible to have to do some work for that same amount somewhere else. Is that not possible? Like to Danielle's point, I think she does make a good point. This is great. I love it, and I would approve it myself personally. But I do hear what she's saying.
Yeah.
And what if we used it? I mean, that's the disappointment about this whole project is the mural's not there. It's kind of hidden. It's like a Easter egg in the you know. So it'd be nice if we had a place to put it where it would be really visible.
So I think. If the commission here agrees that there's not a motion to be made on this, we table it and you give me direction on which way to go, probably multiple fold to continue to investigate what the easement agreement would look like so I don't lose traction here. But also to figure out the square footage that this is so that we understand how far those dollars could go for a mural.
Yes.
And then also I'm thinking out loud and
I'm thinking out loud too about, I also hear what Danielle is saying about the, like spending $1,000 for a year on an app.
We don't know how much it would cost, I don't think that, but also investigating what that cost would be.
Motion seems like it has to contain that, right?
Okay. So it sounds like we need to table this.
I think we just need a little more information,
yeah.
In my opinion, and that, like, also to kind of move a little bit this that we listen to, is I feel that, like, I could see, like, if this was where we ended up going, like, this piece is totally great, and even with, I guess, to me, I think even allowing him to pay for a year would be great, but it like just letting that happen and go naturally. But I don't think that should be necessarily put on us to guarantee that we're going to continue to use that.
Yeah.
So I feel like looking into that app too would be a little bit, give us a little bit of an understanding of like, if we don't use it for 5 years, we're going to be able to bring that like imaging back, you know,
right.
What I mean?
Well, and also if we ever got more murals and we wanted to animate and do more AR in the future, this the company that we want to have service agreements with? That's really good.
Totally.
Okay, so my directives then are to figure out the square footage of this so I can at least have that. I need to understand the exact dollar amount that we're talking about. I also need to continue on the easement agreement and continue to work with the city attorney's office to see what amending the contract is still gonna look like anyway. And I need to understand the cost for the AR application, and we need to, I'm looking at selection panel, but frankly, as a commission, we need to be looking around town. See, the city doesn't own a lot of buildings.
So, one thing about the app I was going to say is, you know, is the subscription for it just for this, or is it citywide? Like, does the city have to buy a seat and a certain number of seats? You know, it sounds like it's sold by views, but does that mean, is it used per month, or is it?
I think so because he'll be able to answer a lot of that because he did all of that work with Fiddler's Green and all of those are animated.
Oh,
so
are they popular with the animation? Like, is this something that everybody's
loving? I'll send that to you all as well.
Because I was going to say for me, I'm just like old fashioned, but I'd rather have another mural than an animation.
Well, so then he's done it before, and that means he's researched the animation companies, is what I would think, because he seems very thorough.
Well, needless to say, this is gonna have, it wasn't going to happen quickly anyway, so we'll just look at this as phase two. Do we want then to dedicate the spoke wall without the second phase? Without it? So we need to dedicate it sooner rather than later.
Do you have to take out an approval on our breaking the easement there? Have we got approval for going down below where we?
No, I have to go back to city attorney for that anyway. We have to amend that easement anyway.
I love the mural though, and I just,
yeah.
My saddest thing is that I wish it were more visible.
So I also would challenge everybody to go over there between now and next month. Please go and visit. I can also ask. I can also ask Lauren if she works for Boulder County Housing Authority, if she has any green. Pedestrian traffic data of how many people go through that breezeway, because maybe our thought of how many people use that versus how many people actually do. And also on Kaufman Street, and Chiquita, I'm gonna look at you real quick, that's that whole transportation. They're ripping the heck out of all of that, and that's gonna be major bus and pedestrian and bike thoroughfare. They're tearing that up next year, right? I mean, it is, that's not a if it happens, that's a when it happens. Kaufman Street from like 2nd all the way to Roosevelt is gonna become a massive bus, pedestrian, and bike, massive bike lanes. They're taking out all of the diagonal parking, and that's one of the reasons that this parking garage and structure was approved in the first place. Because all of that, they knew all that parking was coming out.
Where is that?
All along Kaufman, from like 2nd all the way up to like Roosevelt. It's turning into massive bus and bike lanes. So all along Kaufman there's gonna be transportation madness ensuing. So anyway, my point is, I guarantee that somebody, either the traffic people here in the city or Lauren herself, will have some quantification of how much traffic potentially this breezeway it receives currently and it will be receiving once that project is done.
This is strictly a breezeway?
I wish I had it. Okay, so if you. When you come down the stairs, like this is, so the breezeway in Los Arcos is across here. The distillery is on the left. You walk down here, that's all of the bike things. Then there's the bike lockers, and you continue to walk here, and it goes up to Kaufman. And if you're a car who wants to park in this garage, you come in and you turn left, left into here, and then that takes you up to the parking in the garage. And then if you're walking here, the offices for Boulder County Housing Authority are on the left. So this is basically a pedestrian thoroughfare between Kaufman and Main Street through that breezeway.
And when there are public places, Arch, that's right there.
Yeah, Los Arcos is right there, yeah. Okay, well, so I think I have my marching orders. If anybody thinks of anything, let me know. I'll probably send email updates kind of as a blanket, especially if we get a thumbs down, like, no, that's not gonna happen, or yes, that, you know, I'll send you that. So our direction changes significantly, and then, yeah, if you'll go and visit it, yeah.
Just one comment. I think that this project has to mature up, and we have to. And the reason I say that is because we really don't know what it's going to look like in the winter, and it could be a whole different story. So I think a year and a half of this of a big mural is going to tell a different. It's going to be quite different. I mean, I understand that the best place to see it from is supposed to be the roof, which is closed in the winter.
However, when those trees don't have leaves, it's going to be much more visible. So I think it's going to be a different story of the winter, and I think we need to observe it through a couple seasons and see.
The best place to view it is coming up breezeway. The best place to see it is walking, and if you go visit it, the best place to see it is from when you're walking in the alley. And I don't remember what that theater is. These people.
It's the Trojan.
Yes, the Trojan. Uh-huh. They're getting a grant to redo all their old neon.
Oh, wow.
And they're trying to reactivate their like back entry.
Oh.
And they're working with the distillery. So this alley is kind of like,
you know, getting hit.
Other things are happening on here.
Right. So it does beg the question then of if Boulder County Housing Authority can give us some quantification of pedestrian traffic that they are expecting over the next couple of years, it could be at least a little bit of a crystal ball into, you know, if suddenly these lockers and these bike racks are totally full. Like, that changes this a lot, right?
Is there well, because a lot of traffic there, though, one thing I think is like, where is it? Like, you know, bikes leaning up against that wall and just like finish match there, it really damaged the barrel.
Yeah, we'll have a, we'll put the protective sealant on it. I mean,
I think the bikes are, the racks are set back enough.
Yeah, they have, yeah.
I think that nobody would just lean their bike up against the wall.
I don't know.
The little girls that are at Twin Peaks or whatever the new mall is called, it's called Rocking. Yeah, those little ones, right? It'd be so cool if the building would allow us to put just like one on that outside, a small one like that on the outside wall of the court. So then it says like, come see here or something, you know, like come down the way.
We can talk about easement agreements, but again, I can't stress how, again, it seems like a simple thing of the city and the county shake the hand and everything's cool. Like, that's not how that works.
I think when we go to look at this in the next month, if you're standing in the alley or on Thompson Street and walking by, I think you can see that wall. And if it was full of bright colors, I think your eye would be attracted and you might just go in to look at it.
Yeah, that's
true. I mean, it's going to be, I don't think it's completely hidden is what I said. I think that there's
I think
views.
It's visible from
here. Yeah, we need to
not know. The whole thing maybe, but you're able to see part of it and say, well, what's that?
Would it be something that we could add to the bike map?
Yes.
The pedestrian and bike way.
Yes, 100%. So this bike map needs to be redone, right? And is definitely something we need to work on and not make it just big. So when you're riding your bike, you're like, where am I? That's only good. Yeah, so anyway, this is happening. And in fact, the bike folks in Art and Public Places, it's going to be in Art and Public Places. Centric map, and the bikes will have their own bike-centric map.
I also suspect that if buses are stopping in Hoffman, and they are going to be stopping, and people are going to get off,
oh, yeah.
If they want to go to Main Street, this is going to become very busy.
Yeah. Okay, I'll also find out where the bus stops are. I'm sorry, we spent way too much time on that. We're talking about a fairly significant portion of this budget, and again, I commend the artist for actually having the guts.
Yeah.
Because what's the easiest thing to do? The easiest thing to do is pull the trigger, buy your product that you promised, install it, and be done with it. So, I mean,
I think that just goes to show you where he definitely had that love of Longmont. Kind of instilled in
him. Oh, I forgot to tell you. I'm so sorry. I will send you exactly what he said. He chose roses because of Roosevelt. Because
I figured that was right where my head went 100%.
He went and he was lunched every day on his lunch. Because I guess his grandma lives here or something?
Yeah.
Grandma. Anyway, so that's where he would go on lunch, so that's why I chose one.
I love that rose garden.
Yeah, me too. So at least it's very thoughtful. Yeah, that's
right. Maybe all of you are familiar with Rhino and all the murals there.
Yeah.
So, like, it's become a go-to place. The River North
art district in Denver, because it is full of murals, fabulous murals, and you can get online and find a map that has them all numbers. You can go down there and you can just walk around and then go find someplace to eat. It's become a real destination for that. And I was thinking, if this is animated, if I heard there was something like that and it was, you know, I would travel ways to come see it.
Yes. Well, and also to remind you, once we get through our city council, our charter changes, and once we have that availability to start doing that public, private, our mural program with grants for private businesses, then we have a greater opportunity to help fund murals all over the city with building owners, right? And so I think that there's, you know, we budgeted for that in 2023 with the anticipation that we're going to be able to execute that. So our number of murals, but also communities telling their own voices and their own stories of what's happening in their own neighborhood with around businesses and buildings that is intrinsic to that area of Longmont is going to be. So we have the
channel. So you have your marching orders. Do you need anything else from us?
No, I don't think so. But just, we are sticking a pin in it. No one has the strong desire to make a motion on this one, right?
Yeah. Right. Okay, moving on to number 9, shock art update. Rand, hit me.
I'll tell you what I know, and then you have to go. I drive by Boston in my house. One of my poles is fine, but not started.
I don't think she's done yet.
The two, by the same brain, cafeteria services, whatever, they're both prime, but one is painted with the LPC mural, and it looks finished.
Yeah, she's done.
But did she paint the wrong?
No.
Wrong location?
She painted the one near the westmost one. I hope.
Yes.
East one we're going to do next year, I promise.
Okay. I wasn't sure because there were a lot of trees.
Yeah.
Around the one she.
Yeah.
That was anyway.
Yeah, that's
good. It'll just the only two I've seen.
You didn't see the one on the front page
of
the Times Call on Monday?
Is that the cheese one?
It's the cheese. Yes, that's where my house. I was just going to say.
Yeah. It's on the digital.
There's one
for
Deltona.
It's half done.
I drove past last night when it was late.
Yeah.
Julie's.
Oh, good.
And it looked painted, but it's navy blue, and it was dark. It was a night. So, but I was looking for the prime box, and then I just saw sort of a little chicken as I went by.
So, oh, good.
I think that's.
So, shock art committee, I'll be sending you the people who have said that they're done and ready for sealing, which is great. I think that it's the majority. I think that there's just that one. And then Julie and the communications department have started doing their videos. I can send you. So the communications department decided to go the methodology of, rather than kind of what I was thinking, which was YouTube, with like chapters of like what to do, what not to do, what to expect. Like they're going hipper and cooler and like making them fast 2-minute TikTokies.
Short form content.
Whatever it's called. So anyway, I gave them a list of you have to cover these things and you have to address this stuff. And then Julie, we're gonna pay for your materials and you're gonna do your work and you're gonna give me videos.
So,
well, maybe it should be they do. I know nothing about this.
I just can't.
Just want to do it. Just make a bunch of short and then just give us one big one with all the short ones together.
Melanie, I look at you because I know you post a lot of social content. And I think it will be great, because then the idea from the communications department was every year as Shocker comes up and is going to start happening again, we'll promote our program by throwing these little Shocker, you know, teasers out there. So then I also went back through the content and I said, okay, take away what the stipend is. We just say a stipend, so as that changes or what over time, like at least it doesn't date itself, yeah. You know, those kinds of things. So
excellent.
Yeah. Thank you, Randy.
So number 10, 9th and Alpine, which you've been working on.
Sorry, everybody's already on. So somebody caught COVID and called the artist, and he was very sweet, but he said that he, you know, didn't feel comfortable moving forward. So we're on for the 3rd through the 6th of November. Most of the people who initially had signed up, I'd say half have re-signed up and stuck with their same shifts. So if you would like to, rather than my creating yet another volunteer sign-up business, just sign up for painting shift.
Yeah.
And when you come to your painting shift, you're going to get a job. And it's going to be whatever I need to do, which might be checking people in. So maybe as a good rule of thumb, sign up for a painting shift and come 15 minutes early so you can get your job.
Yeah. And it's November 3rd through November 6th.
Thursday through Sunday. You reserve the right to, if for some reason we get done, to cancel it. I was like, fine. If the weather goes significantly south in the next week and a half, which I don't think it will, you could have adhesion issues, but it's been so bloody warm. I mean, for that ground, for that to get that cold, I just don't see it. I think we're fine. Yeah.
So I'm working the election, so I can't do it yet.
Okay. Just come by and see us. Come say hi. Thank you for your service.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I was going to show up in October.
I know, I'm sorry. I am sorry, but I can tell you, just don't get COVID.
You told me to be on the
Oh, yes. Sorry. And then the artist having the longer conversation about the second side, he has spoken to a local artist who we all love and admire about conceiving of the other side. But I think we're going to do some sort of outreach component from the people who come to participate at 9th and Alpine on specifically on the 4th. Think about doing one of those dot matrix kind of same thing. What is it that you want to see on this? Do you want to see a work box? What do you want? What do you, community, want to see on the other side of this wall? And get some of the feedback that way. So he's going to really help facilitate that conversation. So I think that's what we're doing.
Okay, we had a printing error, and I don't want to use these.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, no.
Do you have any cards? I've got cards. I've got stickers. Is there any other questions on 9th and Alpine? It's just a beta.
And I have heard that the spring extension proposal is at the city.
That's the same. I'm just working on the contract. I'm just going under, not amending it. I'm making a new contract.
So that's the extension. All right, moving on. Gather enough people.
Thank you so much.
You have a quote from an
approved vendor.
For engineering vendor of $46,000 for the removal and rebuilding of the art piece.
So we would be using stickers.
Taking it down, moving it over, putting it back up.
They're
putting together a report with the structural and material recommendations.
Oh, we must be our stickers.
Okay, that's cool. Sorry, forget that.
Yeah, hold on just a minute. Who's a sticker?
We are.
Raise your hand if you're a sticker. Are you out of stickers?
Yes.
Okay. Hand me back the ones that are not stuck. Does everybody need to stand up and stretch?
These are all done.
Not done. Not done. Not done.
got done.
Not done. See, if you would have come early, you would have been a part of the.
Are you talking about not stickers?
No stickers.
Or no stickers, but there was no.
Not first. Okay, so now, hold on just a minute, because if I don't, my brain is so not working.
What are those?
Those are not ones. Okay, so if you're a sticker, raise your hand. Hand me your done. Your stickers are done. Sticker done. Sticker I'm glad that so we're getting this on video. Okay. So Stephanie, can you please bring the ones that have stickers over here?
Those are completely done.
Oh, these are stickered and swiped?
Yeah.
You guys even did that?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, you are so amazing.
We have a swiper.
I didn't even realize. See, this is what happens when you take the box with the.
These are all done, sticker and swipe.
Where did you guys switch?
We just grabbed stickers.
Who needs candy for your good job? Thank you all so much.
Don't let me put those in the box.
Where are we on this?
So we're at number 11.
Did you want
Let's take a timeout.
Did you want us to keep swiping those?
Doing what?
Did you want us to keep swiping the ones that were
used? I don't think we have any more. I don't think we have any more stickers, so I think we'll just leave it.
I haven't done any yet.
Wait, what? Who hasn't done any yet?
I haven't done any yet.
Well, why not?
I've been busy.
Okay, well, get up and do some. You didn't do your red and greens?
No.
Okay. Oh, and Shakita, you haven't either.
Oh, Shakita's here. Hello, Shakita. When did you get in here? I didn't see you.
It's no good.
You have to make it fast. Alright. Imagine, Shakita, that Art in Public Places were to have a tagline or a. Put your red one on the one you love and your green one on the one you're like. Red one, never a possibility, and green would be a book on a quote.
Okay.
And while you do that, Cindy, I'm going to talk about next week. Okay, so gather enough people. The vendor who is a citywide contractor has come back and given us a scope of work for moving gather enough people. And it was very comprehensive. And upon the city engineer's review and parks review and their vast knowledge of these kinds of projects, because just to say, I've installed a lot of artwork, I've done all of that. I have never had to move something like
this.
Right. Okay. I have never had to excavate. Yeah. Do you know what I'm talking about?
Go back to the very beginning. So
yes.
I want to know what this piece is. Just to make sure.
Oh, Isaac Walton. The
Oh, it's the piece that had to be.
So. Gather enough people. It's a long Isaac Walton. The green line, right at the pond. And if you're headed west and you're riding your bike, right now it's just like gravel because when the flood happened, it took all of that out. And so the city remediated it by just putting gravel down. It also is going to, likely that stretch is going to be on your ballot, just so you know. That would be the RSVP business that you're going to be looking at, is that stretch?
Yeah.
Or over is a portion of that project, so just so you know. But needless to say, where Isaac Walton is, that berm, that levee, that dam, from where the river flows to where Isaac Walton is, has to be fixed. And the Army Corps of Engineers is involved. And so years ago, the Army Corps of Engineers and the Parks Department came and said, that piece of artwork is in the way of what it is we're going to be doing. So you have two choices. You can leave it, and we will demo it and take it out, or you can move it. So we are investigating the cost for taking the piece, reclaiming and keeping as much of its guts and all of its bits and pieces as possible. We have selected over these years a location that is sufficient on the other side of the pond. So on the north-ish side, along the causeway, we have checked with the electrical people and that easement. So they have a certain amount of space that they won't let us, the city, invade underneath the electrical wires. So space has been chosen. So now the next piece of all of this is figuring out what it's going to take and how much it's going to cost. That's the backstory. So in the present moment, we got a bid back. It's $46,000, which was way less than I thought it was going
to
be. But there are some pretty, after sending it to the engineers in the city and the Parks Department, who is very knowledgeable, there's some very serious and large scopes of work for this project that have not been allocated, money allocated. So their suggestion is we need to keep working and refining it. So it's gonna be at least $46,000, which we already.
What else needs to be done?
I just need them to give me the answer. But
so they're just saying like overall, specifically not.
The design, the cost to fix the landscaping around, the concrete pouring wasn't included. Like all these, the things that the Parks Department is like, oh yeah, you know, you need this and this and this. Like, anyway, so they gave me a list of things. But the good news is, again, that because this is a citywide award, we don't have to bid this out like normal things, right? Where at a certain threshold of an expense, you have to bid it out and get a number of bids. We don't have to do that here because these people have applied for doing these kinds of construction jobs and they've been awarded this. So we just need to, they have to tell us exactly what they're going to do, exactly how much it's going to cost. And then that's where we look for what's missing. But anyway, so we're moving forward though. That's good because the Army Corps of Engineers is finishing up their design and they're going to bid at the beginning of next year. So basically, we have to have this done or at least take it out what we want before they go in and start demoing. Does that make sense?
Uh-huh.
It's pretty scary, but it's we're moving forward. This is the silver lining.
You don't have to have a picture handy.
Yeah,
it's not too much trouble.
No. So the other thing about other thing that's interesting about gather enough people is I think that, and I'm gonna look at you, Eileen, it stopped working before the flood.
Right.
At some point,
the control bolt, yes,
It's electrical. So, there you go. So, that's Isaac Walton.
The theory is, when you get enough people on the platform, it's like a truck stand. When you get enough people to set a platform down, the mobile opens up into a big butterfly.
And it's a whirly gig, isn't it?
I saw it once.
It's a very important book. We had it to the college.
Actually, but it's been a while.
Never seen it. But you know, all the platform, they have.
What do they say that you need?
Like 10?
How many do you
have somewhere now?
I mean, moms have that weight.
Well, that's true, but how many did you have?
But it's wood and we want to make it like tracks.
Okay, yeah, yeah.
I will be there.
Oh, that's okay.
Okay. Send a group that'll pay for the space.
Okay.
Okay, moving on to union silos. Everybody's here.
So the union silos,
think about it.
So, the structural engineers have gone out there to look at these to see what we need to work on this project.
Yep.
Angela asked them about everything we've discussed about what they need to cover them with. Can we use stucco? Can we do this? Can we do that? You know. And so they are putting together a report with recommendations.
And it's about vinyl, and it's about stucco. They also looked at the ground around them to make sure that we can take equipment. So a person lift, basically. I asked about all of the alternative materials. I also asked about sealant for the rebar, if that makes most sense. They agreed that cladding is probably a good idea, but I'm like, okay, cladding with what, and how much does that cost?
Yeah.
So,
anyway. So cladding might be like stucco coating and
something. I have whatever.
A canvas.
Something.
Yeah.
So when the recommendations come in, I appreciate if Angela would start working on the cost for all those things.
Yeah.
So that we can get a list and see.
Because the last time I looked, a 1975 square foot mural, like we were looking in the 75,000 to 80,000 each.
Mm-hmm.
And that was, let's face it, look, I had a little inflation since then. So
I drove by and it looks like the silos are like they kind of zigzag.
They're far enough apart, I think, that you don't notice when you're driving down.
Yeah. That's, I thought they were going to be like all in a row.
Yeah.
And I was surprised because they were quite staggered far off the road. Yeah. One of them was quite far off the road. Yeah.
And if we can get pricing, they actually give Angela a report and we can get pricing by next month. Maybe we can get a call to artists out by January.
That would be amazing.
That'd be brilliant.
But still, it's a goal.
I think it's totally realistic, but you need to know what you're in for site prep first. And then the other piece of it is if you decide to say, take the first, and we'll Photoshop it so you can take a look at what it looks like, but like say 10 feet and just make that a band of singular color. So when it gets tagged, we just go and paint it that singular color, and the mural, in fact, is
higher.
Well, and then the price from us, you know, all of it. Yeah.
I've been imagining, and I may be wrong.
Yeah.
We have three different artists.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, I don't know.
Yeah.
You'll have to decide. I mean, they obviously need to correspond or be thematically consistent or somehow be similar. And no beer cans. I was like, I do not joke. One of the departments here was like, no beer cans over here.
Why would we do that?
Okay, so
yeah.
13, emerge remediation. Take it away.
You ready?
Yeah.
Emerge is the post on top of the pillars on the bridge that goes over 287 by Dickens Park.
Yeah. This is the one that bothers you. You said your OCD is, it makes those crazy
things not even. I know.
But
that
These ladies. It is a giant hole. And that is not good.
How did that work?
I don't know, but a citizen sent this to me 2 days ago. So I don't know.
What if the rock?
What if the rock?
Rock or something fell off the truck.
So this is when I ask you who needs chocolate, because I hate to be the bearer of bad news, but this is bad. So I don't know. So the contract from the artist is at the city attorney's office right now. He is reviewing a section that talks about alteration, which basically goes back to at what point are we obligated to, we basically have to tell him we have to change this because we have to fix it. Because if moisture gets in there and starts the freeze-thaw cycle, we're in real bad shape. So we need to do something about this right away. That's 2 weeks.
For now?
I don't know.
Could we tarp it for now?
I don't know. So I'm calling a conservator, but I'm pretty sure the way I read the contract, I'll send this to you tomorrow, is that the contract reads that we have to let the artist know that we're making an alteration. The good news is this isn't a public hazard. I mean, that's a good thing, but it's a serious art hazard. So then the artist could come back and say, well, I want to fix it. And then he can bid out and tell us what his cost would be. But that's a state highway, which means that that means CDOT permits. This is a very expensive situation. Luckily, you budget every year in a maintenance fund. And, you know, we are prepared to take care of this because that's what happens with air pollution. So I think what would be in our best interest is if we can approve at least some amount of funds tonight to at least get the conservator going and taking a look at it for the stopgap, that would be ideal. We have a $20,000 budget for maintenance. We easily have five, no problem, to take care of this. We also could encumber funds from next year, get a conservator under contract and encumber the funds next year. But it's a pretty serious deal.
So how much is the conservator, how much do you want us to put the conservator? How much do you want us to approve?
I think that if you could approve at five, what do you think? I mean.
Yeah, I mean, we're close to the end.
So.
Right, so we're close to our maintenance already that we wouldn't have spent.
Yeah, so, I mean, if this project rolls into next year, we have to phase it and some of it comes out this year and some of it comes out next year, that's fine. Procurement rules state that up to $4,999, I can just hire someone. So if somebody comes to me and says, I can put a tarp over this and get it to the point where it will stop it from the freeze-thaw and at least stabilize it for less than $5,000, then I can just spend that and get it taken care of in a short amount of time, and then that at least gets us moving forward before we go into the winter.
Why the city maintenance department? We have someone in the city that can tarp it. We have to hire someone to do this.
Yes, this is this is not a
sidewalk. So because it's an art piece, we need to go to someone who has expertise in the field, okay. So we don't make it worse. Okay. And so, I would be very scared to tarp it. You're going to attract more moisture.
You create a microclimate. Yeah, it's not a good idea.
So.
So I move that we approve $8,000 right now,
okay,
to stabilize it and apply as well to repairing it and then come back with more information.
Okay.
Is that, do we have to bid out the $8,000?
If the $8,000 is for one job, right? So stabilization is one, I go to the conservator who we use, who we have coming to see Nature's Way this month, that's the person I'm going to call first.
Okay.
And say, we have a serious need. I need you, when you're here looking at Nature's Way, to come and look at this and just, you know, tell me. I mean, they're going to have to get a ladder. They're going to have to climb up. They're going to have to, I mean, anyway. Up to 5,000, if they say that they could do a stabilization for the winter time, to get it stable so it doesn't crack or worse.
Oh, that's
for the winter, and then we figure out a permanent solution, you know, that's a route we'll go. But at $8,000, I'll have to get multiple bids. But that's, you don't have to worry about this kind of things. But we need to stabilize this as soon as possible.
Well, what's fastest? I mean, should we just do 5,000?
No.
It's not faster to do that?
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, it's gonna cost what it's gonna cost, right?
Yeah. So you're gonna come back anyway next month and tell us it's gonna be $20,000 to repair it or whatever.
But if you make a motion to approve up to $8,000 tonight, and I go out and find a conservator tomorrow who will stabilize it for less than $5,000, I would like your approval to just do it.
I agree.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Gotta make
the
motion.
Yeah. So Stephanie, that's
a good motion. Yeah. 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 I'll second the motion to allocate $8,000 to hire a conservatorship.
And stabilize. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed?
Thank you. I will try and make it as easy as possible, I can tell you. So
what's
when you're ready to like move traffic.
Just out of curiosity, what is that material? Because I thought those were straight hollow rocks that were painted on for years.
Hollow rocks?
Not hollow rocks.
Solid rocks.
Yeah, solid rocks.
Yeah,
not hollow.
Not
hollow.
Yeah, me too.
Like,
I thought they were solid rocks.
It looks like it was stucco, actually.
Yes.
I think it's
solid rock.
Solid rock, but with the stucco. Yeah, I know. It looks like a hole. That's what I was thinking, but I can see that for sure. Yeah.
Otherwise, it would weigh so much.
I don't know, but I can find out.
No worries. I'm just curious.
Here's the other thing, which is really, I think this is fascinating, but it's because I'm a total nerd, is because of the Visual Rights Act, we and our contract, we have to let the artist know that we are going to what's called alter this piece. The artist might come back and, depending upon what the contract language is, he might want to bid out, even if it's less than $5,000, to do the work himself,
mm-hmm.
because the fix might alter the look and feel, his intention.
Mm-hmm.
So the city attorney is, in fact, even if I get a conservator to stabilize it, I have to let the artist know that we're gonna stabilize it, that it won't change the intention of the piece, but it's only going to keep it sound for now. And then we have to go through the whole fixing it because it's missing a bunch of pieces now. So it's fascinating.
It's crazy.
Yeah. I can't wait. It's terrible. It's gonna cost a lot of money. Yeah. Yeah, it's a good point. Okay, yeah.
Yeah, I was gonna say, similar to that, I was gonna say, what if we, the artist may look at it and say, wow, I've learned something from when I did this, and now it should be the process.
Yeah.
But we should maybe explore that for the entire setup.
We'll
have to do one, and then the next year it's another one.
Absolutely. Yeah, the artist may have said, I have improved my process since I did this one, and now I'm using this product, and it's amazing, and all of that is going to be taken into consideration. We are not just going to jump the gun and like just do something just because, but the conservator is the one who's going to know the best situation to get it so it doesn't get worse. And at this point in time, like we are in art triage.
Yeah.
Like quite literally. Anyway, yes,
I think an umbrella for sure.
Right. I'll take turns standing out there. Okay, but that was my only.
Is that all of our items?
No.
Oh my God. How are we doing on time? Oh, we're doing good. Okay.
We're doing good. New business. Okay, the artwork label project. Iris was supposed to get this report and she didn't show. She's gonna hear from me. We have surveyed 134 components in our collection. Some things are like Roosevelt Park, you have Manilda, G-Rap, it's one thing, but there are like seven things around, so that counted as seven. But Yeah, 42 of them have no labels at all, for whatever reason, being removed or never having been done or whatever. So.
I'm gonna jump in real quick and say, this is a really big deal. She's being modest. She and Iris have been a team working on this all year long. They have audited your entire collection. They have gone and seen every single piece. They have grabbed GPS locations for every single one. They've taken pictures. This is, so she's being very modest. This is a really big deal. So.
Yay, thank you. So one of the things that has come up is that we have two pieces of artwork that have been deaccessioned and removed. The signs are still there for those. We would like to, can I make a motion?
Mm-hmm.
I'd like to make a motion that we remove the deaccessioned plaques from the two artworks and have facilities remediate the Civic Center. One of them is the colorful pages, and the plaque is in a brick wall, so it needs to be taken out and the brick needs to be refaced. And have facilities remediate the Civic Center and rough and ready, if necessary, at our expense, to be no more than $2,000. Rough and ready had a fountain removed from a pond because it was a hazard, but the sign is on a big rock, and the only way that would damaged is if they had to take a big caterpillar in there and lift something up or do something. But mostly it's just to reface the brick in the Civic Center. So we want to do that at our expense, no more than $2,000.
Would it be possible where you're going to reface the brick to actually do like a stucco on that area where that brick is and then put a little...
That would be up to the facilities manager that the Civic Center, they might want it all to look the same as the rest of it. They might just want to have the brick, just, you know, you get a little half bricks.
It's inside the Civic Center.
It's inside the Civic Center.
Yeah.
The sign.
And I think it might be applied to the brick, and they might have to, like, crowbar it off, or I don't know what it's going to take to get it off.
But it really, it shouldn't cost more than
that. It's too bad that they can't just like apply something on top of the plaque that would be an interest, like a bit of bronze.
It's bronze, so it's a three dimensional
plaque. It's like this big.
It's that big.
Yeah.
I mean, it's not
the one for colorful pages is about this big. The rough and ready part is probably about the same.
Our Guzman guy, for example, like if you could tame that plaque and put some tiles on it or something. Might actually be less expensive than pulling out and
we only expect it to cost $200.
Oh, $200.
But we want to allocate $2,000 just in case.
The plaque that's at the park is on a rock. I don't know if Parks is gonna say, we can tear it off with a crowbar. I don't know if they're gonna say, oh, we want that out of here. We are gonna have to bring in a little caterpillar thing and pick up the rock and take it away. I don't know if they're gonna say in the Civic Center, you know, that's easy to do or that's hard to do. Mm-hmm. Like, I don't know, but there's no artwork there, so it's referencing nothing, and it needs to go away. So I absolutely can go to facilities and parks, have them price it out, tell me how much it's gonna cost, bring it back to you, you can approve it, and then we can get it done, or we can approve a certain amount of dollars. I'll go to them, they tell me how much it costs, they do the work, and I'll come back and tell you how much it costs you now. Either way.
Second to the motion.
Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Okay.
And Rough and Ready Park has a lake that if you want to do a new piece of artwork in, we can always consider that.
We have a rock.
You do have a rock. You do have a rock. That's true.
What Iris and I are doing now, after we've surveyed everything, is we're going to change up our plaques a little bit, and we're going to make a little like bike tour or walking tour, maybe downtown, maybe Dickens Park, maybe the Greenway, we're not pictured yet, and do like 10, 12 signs for artwork as samples and put them up so that we can get some feedback to see how people like them and so that people will know this is what the new signs are going to look like. And they're going to be in English and in Spanish. We're going to have QR codes that go to an audio file in English and in Spanish.
And all of this will come to you before?
Yeah, eventually. We're still working. Oh my God, we're still working.
Okay.
So, maintenance sign up.
All right. See this? Okay. Up on the right hand corner near the staple is a number.
Uh-huh.
That's your number. Here is your map.
Oh, cool. All right.
Pick 6 or 5 or 10. Whichever works you want to look at, and we used to do this online sign up. And guess what happened? Everybody would email me, but they didn't know what they signed up for, and they couldn't remember. So you have a map. You have a list. You're going to write your name. You're going to go. You're gonna look at them. You're gonna tell me there's holes in them. You're gonna tell me that blue mirrors have bird poo poo all over and then we need to power wash it.
No,
so,
blue mirrors are good.
Are they?
I did this.
Iris said they have poo poo all over them.
Push it. So
yeah.
You guys go on and take pictures of everything. You take pictures of everything. Wouldn't we just use those pictures?
They're not pictures of damage, things that were obviously damaged, I sent to Angela, but they're not pictures of like bleeding and stuff, they're pictures far away of the
whole just the setting of it. Okay.
So this is your, go ahead, sorry.
The more the merrier.
More the merrier.
The more eyes, the better. The more photos, the better. The more information we can put in the objects files of a snapshot of the condition of the artwork now.
So. And then in 6 months, and then 3 months from then, and then over and over, you were going to do this as long as you were on this commission.
I went to Sandstone Park and I could not figure out where I looked at this map and I went up on the top of the hill and I walked down. I was looking, there's a whole bunch of artwork in Sandstone Park.
Oh, and I think it's in the visitor center.
I have edited this. So those two-dimensional paintings are not included here. A couple of things that we know are in bad shape are not here. Things that are already getting looked at are not here. These are the things that we need eyes on, and I think 6 months is probably, you get tired of looking at something. So like choose a quadrant of town.
I could help you.
They don't do that this time.
Are these on the list of the quadrant? It looks like they're just
no, these are alphabetical and I don't know why I didn't put them in bike map order because that would have made your life a lot easier. But so we're gonna go around or I will let you take this home and bring it back.
Okay.
We don't want to do it now.
Alright.
But the online sign-up did not work. So we have to
let's see how we bring it back.
Alright. So everyone has to sign up for, well, because this is what we're gonna do. Once everybody has picked 6 to 10, I'm gonna go through and your number in your up-hand corner, people who are new, you're at the top of the list. Because you've never done this exercise before, so you get first pick. So yes, Dawson Silver, what can be yours? And all the rest of you can choose that one, guess what? You don't really go see that. Because everybody picks that one. We have to split this up and we have to make it so we have eyes on everything. So we know where there's purpose to be and so on. Everybody sees it because you walk. Everybody walks over, right?
You have questions where this stuff is, but you can see
it. Yes, if you have questions about where it is, that's a good point.
Yes, I know that. Yes.
But then, so maybe at next meeting, we'll go through, we'll do the sign up, we'll make sure that everything is covered, and then we'll also go through the online form again, because the online form makes it so easy for you. You don't even have to think about it. Like, is there an electrical wire sparking next to it in a pool of water? That is bad news. And then it rises to the top when Eileen and I look at them as they come in.
we can just flip a little switch and which ones are in bad shape and they all rise to the top, right? So you might say, and it's completely subjective, this is art, but like pools of water next to plinths and things like that, like those are things we need to address. Something that's chipping, you know, it's old, it kind of looks bad, might not be at the top of our list depending upon where other things fall. Yeah.
Can you send that form out?
Yes, it's a link.
Tomorrow? Yeah.
Yep.
Because I think what I would do is over the next month, I'll just go visit my pieces and I'll bring it back to you.
Okay, however you want to do it. But the reason that I gave you numbers at the top is because, again, like everybody signs up for the same thing, and then there's a certain number of pieces that don't get covered. So I'm going to let two, maybe three per piece, and then I'm cutting off. So you might choose something and you might not get it, right? So pick 6 to 10. Ideally, you're responsible for 6 through the season.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. All right. Don't forget this.
Okay, so we just need to circle
them
on here.
Yeah, circle which ones you want. Yeah, circle which ones you want. You want to do.
Oh, I just definitely have the other person.
I mean, and somebody has said before, like try and find, go to a different part of town. You know, if you go, if you're at McIntosh Lake all the time, don't choose those ones. Go somewhere else.
That's why I went to see the parents.
Yeah.
But finding the golf course was really hard.
Yeah.
I swear to God. It says golf course this way. And I drove around the suburb trying to, I could see it. I just couldn't get into it.
Yeah. And at the same time, you might find a great place and you're like, wow, this is a great place. Like, look at all these people that are around this area. Like, bring that back, right?
Left Hand Park was great. I love that.
The first time I did this, I was assigned the flying trees in Miller Park, and I'm like, where the hell is Miller Park? Are there any more?
Yeah.
We have a lot of parks.
It's really Pooh Miller Park.
It's really what?
Pooh Miller Park.
Oh, yeah.
So you do have a lot of these.
Okay, so this will be fun. Don't forget to bring this back.
Okay.
Okay, good plan. How are we doing? 7:30, we're going.
Okay, November commission training.
So we have a friend from the Community Neighborhood Resources Equity Team who is going to come and give us a training in November. The question for you is, well, twofold. Do we want to have augmented agenda that is only decisions, no updates, and then have the training, or vice versa, training, and then quick, fast meeting. And we could do our kind of like Friendsgiving holiday food thing at the same time, since training is a good time to, since we're all quiet and meeting. Or we can plan the training on another day when we all come back, or we can push it to next year.
How long is it? How long is the training?
That's a really good question. Probably an hour. I mean,
none of us have
an equity
vote. Okay. So we have an, if we do it one, if we have an hour and we have to revisit our Rose Foxmeal, right? Just, that's already something on the agenda next month.
Yeah.
That this is also on the agenda next month, right?
Yes.
And it's due back. I don't know what else might be on there, but at least those two things are on agenda.
Yep.
And
we'd have to cut to the chase.
And the union silos, maybe if those engineers get us to report.
Yep.
Report, right? So, yeah, I think if we can do an hour together and then do an hour of meeting, that we should.
Which may or may not have long.
Right. You can just tell the trainers, you get an hour. you got
an hour. I think that's very, yeah. I think that's very fair.
I mean, maybe they just need a half hour now to respond, but.
That's what we need. You know,
you need to have a goal.
Nope. I just need you to tell me what to do.
Equity training, as in like making sure that you're providing art across the community, across all spots in the community, no matter how much money the neighborhood has, or is that the sort of equity training?
I think what I don't want to misspeak. Providing equitable access and understanding, and making sure that we are using equity lens in everything we do.
Okay.
as people is a pillar of, and frankly, sustainability as well. And I think that those are, the person who's going to talk to us will talk about both of them. But it's something that we need to adopt into our process and learn how to be, how to have a check and balance of making sure that we are using that equitable lens in everything. And so by giving us a training into how do we make sure that we are using that lens, using it appropriately, and also adhering to what the city expects us to do as a governing body of the program in the city.
Did I say that right?
Yeah.
You think?
That's close to
it. Yeah, it works.
Yeah. I'm like.
Thank you for answering.
Yeah. I am.
If Priyam comes back and says it's a 2-hour presentation,
yeah,
can you just let us know? I mean, we can. So
yeah.
All right. So
we can stay till 9, maybe. Or,
yeah.
Okay. Well, on the subject of the equity team or whatever it is, you know, Daniel and I met with them by Zoom to talk about the culvert, the Ninth and Alibi mural, and I mean, these are very important people, very devoted to making Longmont the fair and wonderful place that it is, and make sure that we all know what that means. I mean, I think it's fabulous. I really do. Because I think we can all be more mindful.
Yes.
We all can be more mindful. Some of these old non-equity beliefs and habits have been very deeply ingrained, and it's very important to be mindful for all of us.
I agree. And I think at some point the intention was to have this training become a portion of the boards and commissions training. But raise your hand if you have been to a board and commission training. Less than half.
No.
So to be fair, I think that even boards and commissions, because of COVID, like all of these city expectations of what it means to be a board and commissioner and your role as an ambassador and frankly as a civil servant, I think is lost on a lot. And so we just need to get back into those mindsets, right?
Getting back to that idea, it would be really wonderful if they are going to do that training. If
the board and commission training?
Yeah, if we could record it.
It is recorded.
Oh, it is
recorded. Yep, it's been sent to you, but I can resend it.
Okay.
Holy buckets, Peter, make sure that you have a copy and you are with. Whoo! It's like 2 hours long.
Oh.
It's much better in person. Eugene is so lovely, but some of that legal stuff, I would say that to his face, but I will resend it. I will resend the governance, the board and commission training. And also on that note, there is one seat, of course, available on this commission, and the application closes Monday. And so I anticipate that there will be the new board and commission training that should accompany coming on seats. Okay.
Cool.
Okay, we're all agreed that we're going to have a meeting and the training next month on our meeting day.
Awesome, thank you.
Number D, project assistant.
Oh! So we are one of very few, very, very few programs that the position for 3/4 time benefited program assistant for Art and Public Places has made it through first reading of the budget cycle. The second reading is on October 25th and it is anticipated the council and everyone is going to approve the budget as it's written. So, if that is the case, then I have my marching orders for setting up the job description, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. January 1st, posting that. January 2nd, we're posting that sneaker. And it will probably be up for a month.
So, a full-time job?
A 3/4 time benefit. And it has been benchmarked, so it's made its way through HR, all of those kinds of things. primary roles is going to be all of the back and forth with the city attorney, my favorite things. Back and forth with the city attorney's office, marketing coordination stuff, all of the communication stuff, all those calendars we need to be on. Lots.
All the administrative that takes so long.
A lot of the stuff, so that I can focus on my role of outreach, development, and expanding this program the way that we continue to talk about, to work on drive that. And then Eileen is going to continue to do the collections management portion. And this person will be totally responsible for all of the prime gov and all of that agenda, community business, all of that. So anyway, so that would be really great.
So do we bring in some task force?
Oh, we need to, I need people for the hiring committee.
We need a two-person hiring task force for spring.
Spring.
But we need to set up the task force now so that job duties and interview questions and et cetera can be prepared. Volunteers.
I have no idea what
I'm doing. I have been in the interviews.
Yeah. You hire people all the time.
I've been interviewing for the last 2 months for bartenders, so I'm like so interviewed out right now, but I got you covered if you need help.
Yeah.
So Danielle and the task force. Excellent.
Thank you. So I'm really excited, and I think that it's, yeah.
Okay, and I'm going to, can I change the order of the agenda at this point? I just want to add Shakita back in.
Oh, yay!
Because you weren't here.
We did the talk.
Covered you the first time.
Sorry.
So, council updates from Shakita? Any?
Is there anything you all want to know?
I have questions about RSVP and I don't know how, you know, we can't give a political opinion, but it's been a little contentious about the ballot item and the back and forth of extending the Hover, what do they call it? The Hover stretch or whatever. So has Parks or anybody given you presentation on that stuff? You guys know what I'm talking about?
From Sunset to Hover.
Sunset to Hover, right.
They're talking about making.
It's the next leg of funding.
Or the resiliency.
Or resiliency.
Like path and everything from Sunset Street.
I just read the thing.
Whatever it is.
Oh, like where they are directed.
No, it's over further on.
Widening the river and all of that.
All of that. So the reason I asked.
To affect our Judea that comes out over there.
That's why I asked, is just so you all know that if that ballot initiative does pass, then that means that the details of nature could potentially need to move. And finally, Listening Stone, we would move it, and when the river is rerouted, then we'll reinstall it back to the next to the river where it needs to be.
I love Listening Stone.
Uh-huh.
We need more Listening Stone. Those are so cool.
So I don't know if they've talked about it at all in council. No. It's just one of those things.
Angela would be Steam Hedge.
So. Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, yeah.
That's my understanding.
Okay. Then, Commissioner comments.
Are we doing Listing Hedge? We decided. A Listing Hedge.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, thank you for your service on council. I'm sure it's exhausting right now.
It must be.
Are you exhausted? Are you regretting it?
No. This was so much to learn, so much to do. There's just so much to do. This year, I didn't know that this wasn't a thing. We had 5 executive sessions in a row.
What?
And so, you know, because of the budget and other issues like the gun law and, you know, other things that's going on, like you all don't know about. And so that's, for those of you who don't understand what an executive session is when council get to come together, that's when all of us get to sit together and actually go over an issue or policies, because the law states
or our ordinance, or we cannot, only two councils can really come together at a time.
Yeah.
And talk about any policy issues. It's not a meeting, right, because it needs to be made public, okay? So that's why we have executive session, so that we can discuss this, and of course, always our city attorney is there with us when we have questions, and the city manager. And so that was very tiring, you know, starting at 5 o'clock and then running to city council meeting at 7:00, and a lot of time would be like 7:15, so we just didn't talk.
And then when you eat?
Yeah, that's when they will order us food and everything, and then we eat there. But so this time of year, I'm learning, because this is my first time. Of course, budget time is crazy. And so, you know, this is something that, so when I first got on council, I made a motion to decrease our times, our meeting times to at least 3 times a month, because council was meeting every week.
Yeah.
And our charter states that we only have to meet twice. So when you think that people don't understand it, and I said it when I was quoted in a newspaper, I said it's an equity thing, because 3 of us work full time.
Yeah.
And then you don't even think about the city employees.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. No one can take a 2-week vacation.
Yeah.
Think about that.
Right.
Because we are at council every week.
Yeah.
And you know, that's why only really retired people are like on city council.
Yeah. Yep.
You know, and so people, believe me, I had the emails and the calls, and you know what you did, and you know when you signed up, but no one is thinking beyond that.
Yeah.
Because hopefully everybody said, oh, we want more diverse council. Well, if you want young people, guess what? They may have kids. Again, we're on council every week. So yeah, it is tiring, you know, it's a lot, and then you have to, you know, do your research before you go to council. Like, you don't make a decision, you don't understand it. If you get a 1,300-page packet on Friday, and you gotta know all of that stuff on Tuesday, you don't have a weekend.
Yeah.
Well, and if there's an event on the weekend that you have to be at,
yeah.
You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So,
I'm so thankful. I can't thank you enough, because I do. I watch city council often from home, but I'm home.
Yeah.
It's so much work.
Thank you for being here.
We're so grateful.
We are
so much work. I'm so glad that you're bringing this forward. And it is the growing pains of a growing city like ours. You know, we have changes that need to be made. We have, you know, more improvements, we have stress on the infrastructure, we have everything. And that it does require constant attention. So, I mean, it's just, yeah, but I'm with you, it's like, how are we ever gonna have younger, more diverse leadership?
Well, maybe there's a way to get young people involved, but not have them be city council members, where they're like on a particular task force, or something, not a commission, but a, you know, we put them on a task force for a topic. So it just kind of, I don't know, I'm just thinking about.
Well, I also made a motion. I only have 4 years to do this stuff, so 3 years left. So I came in a blazing. And I was doing everything so quick, they were like, hey, what did we just approve?
Yeah.
So it is budgeted and it has been approved that we are going to have an internship program. And so this internship can be either high school seniors or college students that will, and it's a paid internship.
What?
And if those, it's $1,000, and no, we get up to 5 people.
That's nice.
So if any of those interns come from, and I've been partnering with Front Range, and if any of them come from Front Range will actually give them credit too.
What?
So these interns will come in, the first part of their internship, they will go into the particular department of the city. First is customer service, because
no kidding.
I told them customer service is a must, because if you're expecting these people to serve our community, they have to be compassionate,
that have to be understanding and patient. And so that's number one. But then say for instance that, oh, I want to be an engineer. Guess what department they want to intern? And so that's halfway through, and maybe a couple other departments, they have potentials, and then they come into city, then they come to city council, give us a report of that portion of the internship, and then the other half of the internship, they intern with us.
What? When did this happen?
No.
When did we find out?
Everything is in the budget. I've been working on this, because of that very reason, how can we integrate young people into government?
Yeah.
And people who are passionate about their community. And first they have to learn how the city is operating.
Yeah.
You know?
And it's a big mystery to a lot of people.
Mystery to me!
I just jumped off the plane and they said,
that's not it! I mean, I am!
Also, on that note, the elections staff is trying to get high school kids to be ambassadors for the election. And if you know of any high school kids that want to do that, they can just call the county clerk and recorder, and they'll get hired right away because they're looking for kids, and they're looking for a lot of high school kids as soon as they can get them.
You mean to do people?
They're ambassadors. They welcome people and come in to find out how the election process works, see what we are doing and how we sign up people and what processes. If they have to go through a training, a short training, like a 6-hour training. And so, it's a great way for young kids to see how the election process actually works.
So who's managing the internship? Do we know who's responsible? Right. I just sent a note.
I think Sandy, our assistant, one of our assistant city managers, so she's the one I went to about the internship program. I want them to partner with the Community Foundation and also with the Chamber.
Yeah.
So that those interns can also, if they want to learn more about a nonprofit, then the Longmont Community Foundation can actually assist them with that as well. And then to talk more about business, they want to be an entrepreneur, then you have the chamber as well. So I've kind of thought it through, but Sandy is the one who's really going to kind of, maybe she'll have an intern to help the interns. however it is, I'm telling you, we have to start giving space to our young people to share their voices.
Yep.
And this is going to be their community.
Yep.
And we need to support them. Yep. Whether we agree with what they think or want, it doesn't matter. Let's support them and guide them and teach them. Okay, I understand where you're coming from, but what would happen if this, what would you do if this happened? Mm-hmm. And they're helping them to think and be creative, like what you have on the wall, being a creative thinker. And so that's what we want. That's my heart.
When would this start?
January,
when would it start?
Next year. I'm not sure if it's going to start in January, but I think the internship may be over the summer. So, because we can't really do that with high school students.
Right, right.
And, yeah, so.
If it's hooked to the budget cycle, it can't. They could start doing prep work or whatever, but if it's a funded position, just like our position, they can't start until.
That's if
Sandy
or Sandy. Innovation Center, right? Mm-hmm. The same brain.
Yeah.
So, because they do all kinds of internships through that organization, so the infrastructure they already have in place to go through the Innovation Center might be really helpful.
Okay.
Because all the high schools, feed into the Innovation Center. And my daughter's doing an internship through them right now, and they've developed training for her, and she's officially an employee. We had to go through getting her W-4, all that kind of stuff, but getting the word out would be great to do it through the Innovation Center if you want high school students,
mm-hmm.
right? And then you have the school district to help oversee some of that process, because we do have the issue of under 18.
I'm sure CD and HR, I'm sure they'll do all of the, so we have 5 minutes left.
Okay. We have commissioner comments.
If we find somebody who's interested in structural engineering who wants to shut down the highway, send them my way. Oy vey.
What are these for?
So, those are your love quotes up there. Now, your blue one is your heart and your yellow ones.
So blue is one.
Blue is number one, yellow is number two. Okay. I'm gonna add them up to points. And then you might get a gift. With your new
collab.
Oh, wait.
Guys, before we go to this, are there any other commissioner comments? No, can I get a motion to adjourn?
Oh.
I have a motion to adjourn this meeting now.
Second? All in favor?
Okay. You're so good.
Okay, what is it again? Blue.